You have the brake warning light that stays on like this after starting your engine, or that appeared while driving, or even in my case, turns on and off intermittently, and yet your handbrake is properly released and your car is braking correctly? This video may help you. Hi all. First of all, it is normal for this light to come on when the ignition is switched on. It lights up just to say that the light is not burnt out, and this is the case for all the red lights of the dashboard. It's obvious, but I prefer to say it.
Okay.
Of course, if the light stays on after starting up, there is a problem somewhere. And of course, the first problem you think of is that the handbrake is not released. This is the main reason almost all the time, but on my car, a BMW 5 Series E39, the handbrake has a specific indicator light, like this, with a big P inside. So the problem lies elsewhere. The first thing to do when you have a warning light on the instrument panel is to read the fault codes. On my car it's a round OBD1 plug under the hood, but on most cars it's an OBD2 plug in the passenger compartment like this. First I plug and then I switch on the ignition. Here I am in the brake menu. I start reading the fault codes. And there is no fault code. But in my case that does not mean that there is no problem. In fact, I have noticed that regardless of the state of the light, whether on or not, there is no error code. I find that a shame. It would allow a diagnosis to be made more quickly. At this point, the OBD scanner is not going to be useful to us. I will therefore look elsewhere. The most important thing to check is the brake fluid level. Do it regularly without waiting for a light to come on. It's very simple and quick to do. Well, there it is, a little less simple on this BMW because it is necessary to remove the driver's side air intake. I find it a shame for a control that is supposed to be simple and fast, but hey, that's how it is. First, I take that off. I remove the cabin air filter. I remove the engine cover gasket. I remove the small clip. I detach the air duct here and pull the plastic piece out. Finally, the brake fluid reservoir is here. I can see the level there. It is between the minimum and the maximum. The level, it's okay. Now I will check that the float system is working well. Ah yes, as I told you at the beginning of the video, the light comes on from time to time intermittently. At the beginning of the video it was still on, and now it doesn't light up anymore. Do you see the two wires there? In fact, an electrical contact is made when the brake fluid level is too low. So I'm going to completely empty the reservoir and see if the light comes on. To empty the liquid, I use a suction pump like this one, which will suck the liquid into this reservoir. Brake fluid is corrosive. Try not to get it everywhere. That's it. The liquid level is now below the minimum. I start the car and I observe the light. The brake warning light is on, so the float contact works. I now fill with the liquid. The level is now a little below the max. I start the engine. The brake warning light has disappeared. That means that the float system is working well. If your float does not work, you can change your brake fluid reservoir or simply the cap for some models. Now that you have seen that there is no problem with the brake fluid, the other possibility is to have worn brake pads. On some cars there is a specific brake pad wear indicator. But not on mine, and of course if your pads are worn, replace them. But on my BMW 5 Series, one knows the pads are good. So I will look at the brake wear indicators which are plugged into the brake pads. On this car there are brake pad wear indicators on the front left and rear right. I'm going to look at this on the left front, but it's exactly the same on the right rear. I remove the wheel. And the wear indicator is there. It's just plugged into one of the pads. I will make a small parenthesis on the operation of the wear indicator. There is a contact between two wires melt in plastic. In fact, when the pads are at the end of their life, the indicator will rub against the disc and the contact will be destroyed. There I filed another wear indicator, as if it had been filed by the friction of the disc. And you can clearly see here that the contact is no longer made. Basically, on this type of indicator, the contact between the two wires is no longer made when the pads are worn. But beware, on other cars the brake pad wear indicators are different. There have only one wire and the behavior is reversed. There is contact between the brake pad wear indicator wire and the disc when the pad is worn. Usually, these are pads with the contact melt in the brake lining. You understand. In my case, if ever I have a bad contact in the wear indicator or in its connection, I will have the brake light on my dashboard which will come on from time to time. So if like me you have any doubts about it, replace your brake pad wear indicators. It's quick to do and it's really cheap. I'll show you that. The connector of the indicator is in the plastic cover here. To open it, there are two pull tabs. I pull out the connector and it's the one on the right. The other is for ABS. To detach it, I advise you to pull on the plastic and not on the wires. Oops, and there you go. Even if you are careful, plastics break. This car is over 25 years old and all plastics are brittle. Well, you agree, my connector is broken. You know what? I'm going to replace the connector with soldered wires. The connection will be better and much more reliable. Let's go. So I don't bother to remove the old wear indicator. I cut the wires directly. I free the cable from the metal sheet there. It goes behind the suspension. Then I disengage it from the brake caliper bleed screw cap. Then finally, the indicator is just plugged into the brake pad. I just have to pull it. Here is, it went out. Now I put in place a new wear indicator. I just have to push it into the pad, into the slot. Then I pass the indicator cable through the same place as the old indicator. Then, since the connector on the car is broken, I cut the one for the new wear indicator. Done. It's the same. I cut the broken connector. Then I strip the wires on the car side. I loosen the tape around the two wires a little, then I cut it. In fact, I will lengthen these two wires. Since I lost some length by removing the connector, I take a length of wire that is about the length of the connector I removed, and I pass a self-welder connector. I heat it with a heat gun. And there it is, it's welded. Then I do the same thing with the second wire. Here I let cool, and I test that it holds well. It's good, it holds. It is not mandatory, but to protect a little more, I add heat shrinkable tubing around it. Then I put a little bit of duct tape back where before there was tape. Now that I have extended my wire, I will be able to connect the new pad wear indicator to it using the same technique. I guarantee that a connection like this is much more reliable than any connector. On the other hand, yes, it takes more time to replace. I put it all in the plastic cover and I test. The brake warning light goes off, which means that the connection of the wear indicator is good. So there I did the operation on the wear indicator on the left front, but I did exactly the same on the right rear. I'm not showing you because the operation is strictly the same. In conclusion, the brake warning light may remain on in the following situations. Either you have a lack of brake fluid, and it's so, an electrical contact will be made at the brake fluid reservoir switch. Either you have a worn brake pad or a defective pad wear indicator on the left front. An electrical contact will then open. Either the same thing happens but at the rear right. The electrical contact opens and the brake warning light on the instrument panel comes on. In my case, after replacing the two wear sensors and soldering the wires, the brake warning light no longer comes on intermittently, so my problem is solved. But for you, if after checking all this your brake warning light still remains on, the following causes are possible. It could be a problem with the handbrake sensor for cars whose brake light is coupled to the handbrake. It could be a wiring harness problem with poor electrical contact or moisture, and the solution can take a long time to find. It can also be other possibilities that I have not mentioned, and I invite you to let me know in the comments. I hope you enjoyed this video and that it was useful to you. If so, I invite you to share it, to add a thumbs up, or to consider subscribe to the channel. See you soon on Enjoy Wheels.